It's a sunny afternoon, and Helimed 98 is heading out towards the coast.
Got immediate left.
Details are still coming in, but paramedics Ant and James know this mission could be serious.
We're off to a detail just out in East Yorkshire. We've got reports of an RTC. The cows are rolled over. The two patients potentially trapped, and there's some reports that it's smoking.
Going 8 minutes, I'm just for info.
Yeah.
The team's heading for a grid reference on the main road from Hull to York. But there's a problem.
Struggling on location for this one. We've also just passed the car apparently, so it's obviously well hidden from the plane. There's still other signs to call us, so it's looking like it's nearer to the market weight side, so I'll update you.
Yes, all copied. Intention to pick the 1079 up and track it down towards Market Wheaton anyway.
They're going to have to search for the crash, and ground units are none the wiser.
NS98, we've got visual with the ambulance resources. We've also got fire appliances going back up the 1079. The crew's actually booked on with this detail.
It's still struggling to locate the car. They've basically driven up and down past this car several times. Have you got any visual from there, over?
There's no... Where the resources are, there's no accident.
No, there's no with the aim.
Then James spots a vital clue.
Fire appliance down here now, mate. 1 o'clock on the nose.
Ali?
Yeah. They come off the road.
Right. Brownfield it is, guys.
Yep. 9A located the scene going into land.
They're touching down next to dense woodland.
It might be on its side, mate, actually.
I just wonder if we can get through there.
The car careered deep into the trees. It's all but invisible from the air and the road. Firefighters found it by chance.
How are we doing, guys? Can we get in here? What are we looking like?
Two
traps. Any obvious injuries?
Yeah, just go back neck. Quite an angle, the lower back injuries.
Two patients? Yeah, two in there, mate.
First, James and Ant are going to have to work out how to reach them.
We just get eyes on and just have a quick chat if you guys are happy. Airdesk Medic 1, quick update, fire and rescue on scene. Vehicle's in the hedge, on its side, passenger side down, two patients.
The car's jammed up against trees. If the occupants are injured, removing them will be very difficult.
If we get windscreen out, they might be able to help us all. If not, we'll just get up to drop room.
Firefighters have started work and cut away part of the windscreen.
So, obviously, you're in a really uncomfortable position here, aren't you?
Yeah. So, as far as you're aware, no,
just my arm.
Just your arm that you've been laid on.
Okay.
Amy Horner was driving her boyfriend, Josh Longdon.
I think if we get you out first, love, I think we're going to be able to swing your legs out and we'll bring you out that way. So just bear with me for a couple more minutes and we'll have you out, all right?
Their injuries don't appear serious, but Ant knows that appearances can be deceptive.
In terms of your back pain,
yeah.
Is that your worst pain or is it your neck pain?
My back's the worst.
So your back's the worst, yeah. So
yeah.
Just give my fingers a squeeze. Yeah, on that side.
Yeah.
Can you feel me touching you? Yeah. Okay, if I ever feel your legs, can you feel all that?
Yeah.
Yeah? Both sides?
Yeah.
Yeah, both sides, yeah.
Anthony's had a quick look, we've spoken to him through the window and we're just getting fire and rescue just to create some space at the moment and then we'll update and see what injuries they have got. They're both conscious and alert, so at the moment they both seem relatively stable, but we will obviously, once we've got access to them, we'll be able to see if they have got any injuries and then we can create a plan as to how we're going to get them out.
Amy's position and her back pain suggests she may have a spinal injury.
So if we turn it round, so we're head at this end, I'm going to bend the knees up, slide around and then just bring her out. We've got this kind of covering the glass up.
This will be a tricky rescue.
It's just going to be getting her kind of over it, basically. Right, yeah, we're in now. So if we bring these legs around...
It's vital Amy's spine is kept straight.
Oh, my body.
There we go. Good stuff. Right, now if we can...
Put that glass down there.
So if we just do it gradually and work yourself around, that's it.
You okay, Josh?
That's it. Let me just come out this way. Okay, just keep hold of my arm, love. And if we just bring her out onto the skid. Yeah, that's all right.
Fine, honestly.
You've got it, yeah.
Back to the drill bit.
Yeah, I've got it.
Right. Well, then you're out.
Okay, my love.
You're out.
They need to examine her back urgently.
Right, we're going to get you out of these woods and have a good look at you. Okay. Just make sure everything's okay.
And her symptoms are concerning.
Well done.
No, so it, oh. Is that due to pain? Right, knock it up. Okay, love, I know this is... So this is all precautionary, all right?
Yeah, yeah.
Right, we're good to go.
You can phone a chain if you want.
Yeah. You're just going to be able to get yourself out then, mate, yeah?
You ready?
Yeah, ready, steady, lift.
Amy's heading out of the woods. Now Josh can make his escape. His seatbelt protected him from major injury.
They've had quite a fright there. They've left the road. It looks like they've definitely rolled and maybe turned a couple more times than that and crashed through some bushes. And they've been stuck in the car in a fairly uncomfortable position for around about 40 minutes. So, with all that in mind, yes, she's a little bit upset, but they're kind of reasonably calm.
I'm not surprised. It wasn't. It wasn't a position you choose to relax in, that, is it? Yeah.
The accident has happened less than 20 miles from the major trauma centre in Hull. It's decided Amy will travel by road, so Josh can travel with her. Only scans can reveal the cause of the pain in her back.